Hello, it is Carmen of RedefiningWidowhood.com. Welcome to my channel. In today's video, we're going to be talking about how loss of spouse affects identity. Again, in today's video, we're going to be talking about how loss of spouse affects identity. Now, before I get into the video, I want you to do me a favor and I want you to hit that subscribe button. I also want you to turn your notifications on so that you're notified anytime I drop a new video. So again, I am Carmen. I am the creator of RedefiningWidowhood.com. I'm also a certified life coach and a resilience strategist. I help women to find and create a pathway for joy. So in this video, we're going to be talking about the loss of a spouse and how it affects identity. I have been on the journey of figuring out life and living life after the loss of my late husband since December 2018. And I have learned so many different things along the journey. One of the biggest things that I learned early on is that the loss of a spouse affects your identity majorly. What I mean by that is, within the blink of an eye, you're no longer the same person that you were. However, you don't know this new or different person that you're becoming. So it thrusts you into a journey of figuring out your identity. And it takes a while. Once you get through those beginning phases of widow fog and widow brain, it takes you a while to realize, hey, I'm not the same person anymore. I have to make a decision to either go on a journey of redefining my identity, or I can stay in this sunken place of not really knowing what's going on. So I want to talk about today three key areas that are affected as it relates to your identity after the loss of a spouse. Number one, the first area is your relationship status identity, okay? Within the blink of an eye, again, you're not married anymore. However, you still feel married. I'll never forget the day that I was sitting inside of a sermon at my church in Atlanta, and my apostle at the time, he was doing a relationship series on dating, and he was doing it from the perspective of dating as a Christian, the biblical way, dating as in working towards getting married and also dating your spouse. And I was sitting in the sermon, and in my mind, I was thinking, gosh, this is a great service, but it doesn't apply to me. It had been maybe 3 or 4 weeks since my husband passed away. And it was in that moment where I was like, I'm kind of in my own space, my own land of like, I'm no longer married, but I still feel married because my husband just passed away 3-4 weeks ago. However, if people were to look at me, they would consider me single because most people only acknowledge single or married. But in reality, I am a widow. In fact, I was a young widow at the time. I became widowed at the age of 38. So in that instance, I realized how my relationship status identity was greatly affected. Was I still a wife? Was I still a missus? Was I single? Was I still married because I felt that way? Or was I to take on the technical term of being widowed? And that's how this channel initially started off as Single Married Widow, but I recently changed the name to Redefining Widowhood. So number one, your relationship status identity is greatly affected. The second area of identity that's affected in widowhood, and this is for those of you who have children, is your parental identity. You go from being a married mom to being a mom, a widowed mom, a single mom. And I was one in the very beginning. I didn't want to be called a single mom. I didn't embrace that term. It was no disrespect towards single moms because I was raised by a strong single mom. But in my mind, I had done everything right to make sure that my daughters were not the product of a single parent household or a single mom household. I got married, I did everything right. I went through the peaks and the valleys of marriage, and I always kept my children at the forefront thinking about how they would grow up if they didn't have their father and their mother married. So your parental identity changes, and it's like you go from partnership parenting to solo parenting in the blink of an eye. You don't have the help of your partner to put the kids to bed in the evening. You don't have the help of your partner to help the kids with their homework. You don't have the help of your partner to make those pivotal and impactful decisions that you would normally go to them with regarding your children. So that's another way that your identity is affected. And the third identity aspect that is affected during the loss of a spouse or after the loss of a spouse is your financial identity. Many of you went from a two-income household to a one-income household. Some of you who were like me, because I was a stay-at-home mom at the time of my late husband's death, and my husband was the primary breadwinner, we went from one income to no income within the blink of an eye, and I had to figure it out. And some of the questions that come along with that, with your financial identity changing, is, will I be able to maintain our lifestyle? Some of the questions that I had to ask myself were, will I be able to still take care of myself and my children the same way that we were used to being taken care of? So those are three main ways that your identity is affected after the loss of a spouse. Number one is your relationship status identity. Number two is your parental identity. And number three is your financial identity. So if you are in the beginning stages of widowhood, or if you're a little bit further along and you're at that space where it's kind of like, I don't really know who I am anymore. Like, my identity has been greatly affected. Know that you are not alone. Know that this is a normal part of the journey, and know that you can indeed redefine your identity as you go along. So again, my name is Carmen of RedefiningWidowhood.com, certified life coach and resilient strategist. Before you go, I want you to make sure that you like this video, leave me a comment, subscribe, and turn your notifications on so that you know when I go live. And then I also want you to visit the description section so that you can join my brand new email list. So thank you so much for checking this video out. I hope to see you on the next one. Peace and blessings on your journey.